chapter 2, verse 20. For what glory is it when you shall be buffeted for your faults? You shall take it patiently. But if when you do well and suffer for it, you take it patiently, this is acceptable with God. I remember a few years ago, I saw a picture of a group of Christians and some pastors in Africa. I don't know which country it was on, but it was a place where they'd experienced severe persecution. And it really sent a shiver up my spine as I looked at the picture. And I knew that some of these pastors had experienced persecution. And I saw a face of one pastor. He had a lovely face. And as I looked at his face, deep, deep brows of sorrow was in his face. I could see that some of his congregation had been killed. I could see in his face, he suffered for the gospel. But I could see a sweetness in his face. I could see the Spirit of God in his face. It says there, 1 Peter chapter 2, verse 20. It says, "For this is thankworthy, if a man, for conscience towards God, endure grief, suffering wrongfully." We've got to face the fact that we're going to enter into suffering more and more as time goes on in these days. We've got to face the fact that some pastors that we know will be put into prison, even in the UK. We've got to face the fact that street preachers are going to be put into prison. We've got to face the fact that we're going to get beaten up when we're going on the streets giving out tracts. We're going to have to face the fact that persecution is going to come more and more to the church. There are churches in Nigeria, in some parts of Nigeria, that people are getting killed. There are churches in Syria and Iraq that have been decimated, where people have been murdered and killed. We need to count the cost. Let me ask you something. Are you willing to suffer for the gospel? Are you willing to suffer for Christ? Because you're going to suffer more and more as the days goes on. We're going to see who the real Christians are, because we're going to see a lot of these happy-clappy churches with the happy-clappy people empty when the government starts locking up pastors and street preachers and starts saying, if you are a Bible-believing church, you should close because you're homophobic. And then I'll see you guys, and we're meeting in a house because we can't rent a building. And what are you going to do? Say, oh, I'm not going to meet with Pastor Kim. He's meeting in a house. He's seen as homophobic because he's Orthodox Christian. Who are you going to stand with? Are you going to stand with the world? Or are you going to stand with the true people of God who are being persecuted and trying to be stamped out by the government and by the secularists? Or are you just going to cave in to what they're saying? You're going to suffer. You're going to suffer. The church will suffer. But the church that suffers is the church that has the glory of God and the glory of Christ and the blessings of God. The church suffered in the book of Acts, but God moved mightily. The church suffered in the first 300 years of the history of the church. Persecution upon persecution. Nero put Christians up on stakes and set them alight all across Rome. But the church was powerfully blessed. So we're going to suffer, but we're going to see glory and power and God move. Amen. When Christ, says Dietrich Bonhoeffer, calls a man, he bids him come and die. When Christ calls a man, he bids him come and die. I'll tell you this, my friends, I don't care if Theresa May was here, I don't care if all of Parliament was here. I don't care if the Queen was here. I don't care if all the bishops were here and they told me the Bible is not the Word of God and they're going to put me in prison. I don't care, because I've made up my mind that I'm going to stand for Jesus.
Amen. Amen.
I'm going to stand for my Lord. I don't care if Boko Haram came here now with their machetes and they said, stop your preaching. I'll stand.
Amen.
And I'll preach the word. And they can cut my head off. But I'll preach the word. And that's the fire that's going to burn in your heart today.
Amen.
Finally, the shepherd and the church. 1 Peter chapter 2, verse 21. 1 Peter chapter 2, verse 21. For even unto you were called, because Christ also suffered for us, leaving us an example that you should follow his steps. You should follow his steps. It's all about Jesus. Whatever happens in these coming days, let's keep our eyes on him. Let's focus on his life, focus on his atonement, what he did for us, his suffering, his death and resurrection. Paul said, for me to live is Christ. Let us be besotted with him. Let us think much of him. Let us adore him. Let us glory in him. The angels worship him. They say, worthy is the Lamb. So let us, whatever's going on in our lives at the moment, whatever the problems are in this nation, and there's many problems we can see, whatever's going around, let's keep focused on Christ. Let's be besotted with him. Let's continue to worship him. Let's enjoy the blessings that my brother was saying, that we have all the blessings in Christ. Let us rejoice in the glory. We're going home to glory. We're going home to God, where the glory is, the glory of Zion. There's glory upon glory, and let us magnify the Lord. Let us worship the Lord. Let us enjoy our Savior and praise him much in this barren land. In conclusion, and let us walk in love. If you go back to 1 Peter chapter 2, if you go back to 1 Peter chapter 1 first, chapter 1, verse 22, it says, seeing ye have purified your souls in obeying the truth through the Spirit unto unfeigned love of the brethren, love of the brethren. Chapter 2, verse 17 says, honor all men, love the brotherhood. Chapter 3, verse 8 says, finally, be you all one mind, having compassion for one another, love as brethren. Chapter 4, verse 8, and above all things, a fervent charity among yourselves. For charity shall cover the multitude of sins. And chapter 5, verse 14. Greet ye one another with a kiss of charity. Whatever we do this season, whatever we do in our ministry, whatever we do in our life, it means nothing if we don't have love. So let us pray that we have more love for our families, more love for one another, more love in ministry, more love. Let's pray that we have more love, because if people see that we love one another, if people see love, then they'll be attracted to the Lord. And all of us need encouragement. All of us need love. We need to know that we're loved. We need to tell each other that we love each other. I found a brother today, and I was talking to him this morning, and he said, love you, Jay. And it was just a blessing to know that. A brother, he's not my real brother, he's just a Christian brother, but he says he loves me. And it's a blessing when you know that people care about you in the church. So let's express love to one another and encourage one another. God bless you.
Amen. 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 People today...